Excuse me.
I'm a fan of Oak for Show. Tell me about his equipment, what he does, how he does it.
Really, I didn't really get a lot of time. I just kind of saw him. You know, I didn't really get a chance to really talk to him. I didn't really pay attention to what he was having, but I just kind of was like, hey, you know, you know.
He's the one that inspired me.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's been at it, what, for, I don't know, how long? A month, two, three, 4 months?
Oh, I met him like a lot. A few months ago, you know, so I didn't really get to, you know, talk to him.
Were you in Oakland when you met him?
Yeah, I met him in Oakland.
Were you at some actions in Oakland?
No, I wasn't. But what was funny was when Scott Olsen got hit.
Yes.
I was in Oakland the day before it happened.
Yeah.
I had a chance to stay in Oakland that night, but I decided to get back to Fresno and wake up in the morning and realize that all that went down, you know, and I was like, I could have been there. I had mixed feelings, like, if I was there, you know, like, did I want to be there or did I want to, you know, kind of be glad to be back home? But now I'm thinking I kind of wish I was there to actually witness it, you know.
But still, after you were in Fresno, you did, when did you join or get back? You got in here to the caravan, so when did you get back into the Occupy doing?
Oh, I've been the Occupy movement since October.
Hello.
Fresno started on October 9th, Occupy Fresno.
Yeah.
And I started within the first week.
There you go.
I was working, like, I'm a pedicab driver. You know what those are?
Yes.
The bikes with the seats in the back.
Yes.
Yeah, I do that. And I was working the Fresno Fair, and I get a call from my friend. He was like, dude, when you're done, come down to Courthouse Park in downtown. And I'm like, why? He's like, because we're occupying Fresno. And I'm like, what's that? You know, I never heard of it. And so he's like, just get down here, dude. I have to go by there anyway. So I was like, might as well check it out. Go down there, and they tell
me. On your pedicab?
Yeah, well, I had to ride my pedicab to the fairgrounds and then ride it back to the, you know, to downtown.
Yeah.
And so, you know, I pulled up in the pedicab, which is really cool. And, you know, so they tell me about it, you know, everything that they're fighting for. And I agree 100% with them, you know. And so I just joined them since then. Stayed out there, been arrested with them. You know, we still have our encampment. 256 days today.
In Fresno?
In Fresno.
Excellent.
Yeah. And really what happened was, our first month we had a permit.
Yeah.
And so when our permit expired November 1st at 12 a.m., which was Halloween night.
Right, right.
And so we were trying our best to get as many people out there as we can, because we didn't want to file another permit, because it was going to say, like, we can camp here, but we can't sleep here. We can't be here overnight, because the park closes from 12 to 6, you know, midnight to 6 a.m. And we're like, no, we want to be here 24/7. We're not going to accept that, you know? And so we had over 300 people out there in Fresno, one of the most conservative cities in the United States. And, you know, just most of them just willing to get arrested, you know. They never showed.
What, the police?
Sheriff, like, it's county property, so the sheriff never showed, you know.
Yeah.
And then so about 7 nights in, we're down to like 20 people, you know. We're just camping out. And then the sheriff, like 40 to 50 sheriff in riot gear and everything, come up. And we're like shocked, you know, because we're like, oh, they ain't going to come, you know, whatever. They really don't care about us, you know. Like we're not really doing anything wrong, you know. And so we're not causing problems. So we just figured they wouldn't come. And so they came out. We started calling everyone, you know, everyone we could. And we got about 15 more people to show up. And I believe 15 people were arrested that night. But, like, willingly arrested, you know. And so, you know, all they did, like, we have a rotunda, you know, like a giant rotunda. We call it like a gazebo, you know. And they just had a giant Occupy Fresno sign, like, tied to it. And they all stood in a line and just all shouted, hell no, we won't go, Occupy Fresno.
Thank you.
And, you know, and so, you know, they started arresting them. You know, they gave the disperse order and everything. And 13 consecutive nights of arrests. We got up to 99 arrests.
Hello.
And really what we did was we were allowed to move like 40 feet away, which is like across the parking lot, onto the sidewalk. And the sidewalk is city property. So the county can't touch us. They say, oh, you can go to the sidewalk, but you can't be in the park, you know. And so what we did was we kind of started sleeping on the sidewalk right there. And in the morning, we just moved back
10-4
into our occupation. So we still have a 24-hour presence. We're just not in the exact location, but still the same, you know, location.
And within half a block or less.
Oh, like from here to there.
Oh, you're talking 100 foot.
Yeah. Like maybe a little shorter, actually.
Yeah, not far at all. Yeah.
And so, we had 105 total arrests.
Hello.
And that finished. But our legal team, we had a pro bono legal team.
Good.
You know, and they were great. We actually took them to the federal court, federal judge in San Francisco.
Okay.
And we got 2 out of 3 charges they were filing us were unconstitutional. One was holding signs and passing out handbills. Second one was being in groups more than 10, you know, unlawful assembly. And the third one we couldn't get past was closure hours, being in the park past midnight to 6. But 2 out of 3 ain't bad, you know. And so we came to agreement with the county saying, like, we'll be there for a year, you know, from starting July 1st, I believe. And we're still there, you know, obviously. They can't really kick us out. And we only get 3 24-hour vigils, you know, inside the park. The only thing is we couldn't sleep. We can't sleep.
No.
But I don't really kind of find that a victory. I mean, semi-victory, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, 3 is better than 0, but I wanted to be out there every single night, you know. But all charges have been dropped, so no one has been charged, you know. And
I like the idea that the two unconstitutional things, the freedom to assemble and express yourself, the federal judge, immediately, if you will.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I mean, there's no contest. He's like, looking at the ordinances, it's like, are you kidding me?
Thank you. Yeah. You know, he should have. But so to this day, if I was to go to Fresno today, from 6 o'clock in the morning to 12 o'clock, there'd be somebody on the county park doing?
Well, not exactly till 12.
Yeah.
You know, we kind of like, we don't stay until exactly 12, you know, we kind of go to sleep so we can actually get up by
the next day,
you know,
yeah.
And, but on weekends, what we do actually is kind of flip it, instead of being like in the park, well, we're still in the park, you know, but like every morning on weekdays mornings, we have to disassemble our tents and everything, you know, clear the sidewalk and, you know, so we can move back into there. But on weekends, parking is free.
Yeah.
And so what we do is we put it in our tents in the parking stalls. And all weekend, you know. And so all weekend, we just leave our stuff there, you know.
Yeah,
and,
you.
Like, we keep an eye on it, obviously.
Yeah.
Someone's obviously there 24/7, you know. Yeah.
Fire watch.
Yeah. And so, you know, we're still fighting over there, you know.
Do you have a live streamer?
A live streamer
or a video guy there?
We used to, and really it kind of started falling apart after the arrest. You know, a lot of the main people that showed up didn't really show up anymore. And so,
but I can still go to Facebook for Occupy Fresno.
Oh, yeah, it's Occupy Fresno CA. Yeah.
CA, yeah.
Yeah, just add the CA thing. Because what happened was, I think we had an Occupy Fresno. Or I think we started with the website first. Occupy.
Yeah.
We tried OccupyFresno.com, but I guess someone already like bought that. And we're like, okay, OccupyFresnoCA.com.
Yeah.
You know, because that one wasn't taken. And so,
after we had our equivalent, what I call the apocalypse, it was on November 17th, and the cops came down with the helicopters and the horses.
Mm-hmm.
We had one website, which we still have, but we had about 4 or 5 different Facebook pages.
Yeah.
Sprout up. You know, I mean, you had Fort Worth, DFW, you know, but those, after a while, have kind of coalesced and come back together, and we found how to use Facebook to kind of bring, and for a while, it was kind of discombobulated, but now we're slowly bringing it all together, you know.
Yeah. All right, here's something funny, though. All right, like, we had news media big time out there, right? And so, when our arrest started, you know, news media would be out there, and, you know, they would be, you know, arresting us, and so after people get arrested, people that didn't get arrested would walk up to the jail, just sit down in the lobby and just wait for them. And they have just a little TV in there, you know, and only has kind of local channels. And so it's mainly news at night, you know. And so we would just sit there and we'd watch the news, and it was like, they're like, hey, there's us. And then the person like working the counter would just turn it off or whatever. Just all pissed.
Because,
And so, you know, I kind of found that funny. And then like, whenever someone came out, you know, we all like cheered, you know.
Yes.
It's like, yeah, well, congratulations, you know.
Yes.
And
solidarity. Exactly.
Solidarity, you know.
Exactly, yes.
We've got to be there for our brothers and sisters.
Yes.
And
we had about 3 different series of arrests, and we would do that. Well, for me, you know, I lived at the house, and I would visit the park every other day. But what some people would do is they took sleeping bags and, in essence, slept like you guys are talking.
Yeah.
On the porch out in front of the jail, you know.
Well, we never slept in front of the jail.
You go into the lobby, I guess.
Yeah, we just chilled in the lobby and just waited for him, you know?
Yeah.
I mean, it was open 24/7.
So
we could just go in there, you know? Yeah. And that's where we, like, in downtown, like, a lot of places close early.
Yeah.
Like 5 o'clock. Everything's just closed, right? Yeah. So restrooms, the only place we can really use the restrooms is either a porta potty or the jail. And so I always go to the jail, you know? It's like, they always see me, and I'm like, waving them, hey, and they're like, hey, you know? Yeah. And so...
about to run out of battery. What is your name?
Chilton, or Chilton. Chili for short.
Chili.
Yeah.
Thank you, Chili, from Occupy Fresno.
That's right.
Excellent. See, oh, wait a minute. I'm getting the bleep. I'm about to run out.
All right.
There we go.